Hello students, today we are going to discuss the equation for mass parabola for isobaric nuclei. As you all know, what do you mean by isobars? So isobars are those which have same mass number, that is capital A mass number, number of nucleons is same but they have different atomic numbers. Means there must be some different elements which have the same number of nucleons, that is capital A mass number A, but they must be having different atomic number. Suppose we have, for example, 1H3 and 2 Helium 3, in which both have three number of nucleons but they have different number of atomic number, that is hydrogen is having one atomic number, helium is having two atomic number, but their mass number is same, that is 3. Such are called isobaric nuclei. So we consider for odd number of nucleons. In odd number of nucleons, what is the equation of the semi-empirical mass formula that we have already calculated in the semi-liquid drop model, where it was that the mass of the nucleus was found to be mass of hydrogen into number of protons plus mass of neutron into number of neutrons, that is given by A minus Z, minus A1 into A, that is the volume term, plus A2 into A raised to power 2 by 3, that is the surface term, A3 Z square upon A raised to power 1 by 3, that was due to the Coulombic force, Coulombic term, and the fourth term, that was the asymmetric energy term, that was the A4 A minus 2 Z ka whole square upon A, and there was one more contribution, that was the pairing effect. So pairing effect for odd nucleons has been neglected, it has been considered as zero. So we have only four terms for the binding energy. Since the pairing energy is zero, so we can rearrange our semi-empirical mass formula and we have written this equation. Now since this equation is a quadratic equation in Z, so we have written that A into coefficient of A is Mn minus A1 plus A4 plus A2 A raised to power half. And the coefficient of Z is MH minus MN minus 4A4. And the coefficient of Z square is A cube upon A raised to power 1 by 3 plus 4A4 upon A. So this seems this is a quadratic equation and we have the different coefficients of Z square, Z and the constant. So from the quadratic equation we can solve and find one particular value of Z at which we will have the most stable isobar. So that value of Z for which we have the most stable, that value of Z would be called as a nuclear charge, and for this the number of nucleons or the A value is fixed because we are considering isobaric nuclei. So we have denoted that the coefficient of A is alpha, coefficient of Z is beta, coefficient of Z square is gamma. So we have to find the most stable, so using the conditions of maxima and minimas, we take the first order derivative of mass and differentiate with respect to Z and equate that equal to 0. And if we do the second order derivative and the second order derivative is less than 0 for that particular value of Z, then it would be a maximum value, and if the second order derivative is greater than 0 for that particular value of Z, then it is a minimum value. So delta M by delta Z at constant A is equal to 0 gives, when we differentiate this equation, we have alpha A is equal to 0. So we have beta Z differentiation 1, we get beta, and gamma Z square differentiating, we get 2 gamma Z. So we get beta is equal to minus of 2 gamma Z. So when Z is equal to Z naught, because so when we take Z is equal to Z naught, that is the most stable isobar, that atomic value, it would be given substituting Z equal to Z naught in this equation, we get 2 gamma Z naught plus beta equal to 0. So what will be the beta value? Beta will be equal to minus 2 gamma Z naught. So when we substitute this beta value in equation number 3, we get the mass value for the most stable isobar, that is for Z naught. So we have the equation MA Z naught is equal to alpha A minus 2 gamma Z naught. For Z also we have substituted Z naught plus gamma Z naught square. So by, we have seen that here it is minus 2 gamma Z naught square plus gamma Z naught square will be equal to minus gamma Z naught square. So MA Z naught will be equal to alpha A minus gamma Z naught square. So For MAZ, the value will be alpha A. Substitute the value of only beta in this. We get minus 2 gamma Z naught into Z plus gamma Z square. So this is the equation for MAZ and this is the equation for MAZ naught. So if we subtract MAZ and MAZ naught, the final resultant equation we get is alpha A minus 2 gamma Z naught Z plus gamma Z square minus alpha A minus gamma Z naught square. So alpha A and alpha A gets cancelled and we get gamma Z minus Z naught ka whole square. So it is A plus B, A minus B ka whole square formula. So we get, taking gamma common, we get Z minus Z naught ka whole square. So what is this equation? So this equation is a parabolic equation. Supposingly if we plot this value as Y and we take this as X. So what is this? This is Y is equal to MX square. This is the equation of parabola. So we can say that equation number 7 can be plotted as a parabolic curve. So that is why this equation is called the parabolic mass relation. And since this has been calculated for odd number of nucleons, so we have written that it is a mass parabola relation for odd A isobaric nuclei. So using this formula, we can calculate the transition energies that are required in the reaction when a beta decay is there, when a beta positive is emitted out or a beta negative is emitted out. So we can calculate the transition energies. The Q value of the reaction can be calculated. So when Z changes from Z plus 1 or Z changes from Z minus 1 at constant A, which is happening in the beta minus or beta plus decay, so there we can calculate the Q value of the reaction or the transition energies that are involved in the reaction can be calculated. So let us proceed further for the calculation of the Q values. So considering the beta minus decay, what do you mean by beta minus decay? Beta minus decay means that an electron is ejected out of the nucleus. So if we take the parent nucleus as X, so we have Z as the atomic number and A is the number of nucleons. So when electron is ejected out, we say a beta negative particle is ejected out. So to conserve the reaction, we conserve the Z on the left hand side as well as on the right hand side. So Z has to be same both on LHS as well as RHS. Since there is a minus 1 in electron here, so what will be in the daughter nucleus? It would be Z plus 1. So that Z plus 1 minus 1 is again equivalent to Z, which is both on the left hand side and right hand side. Similarly, since electron has 0 here and X was having A number of nucleons, so Y is also A. So both the daughter and the parent nucleus have A number of nucleons, which is said to be the isobaric nuclei. So we are calculating the Q values for the isobaric nuclei in this reaction. So what we see that the Z value has changed from Z to Z plus 1. So that is why we have written here that this is a transition for Z to Z plus 1. So the Q value is always given by the difference of the masses of the reactant and the product. So what we do here, we add and subtract MAZ naught. So when we subtract here, we add here MAZ naught. So it does not make any difference in the relation. So putting the value of equation number 7 to this equation. So for MAZ, we put Z minus Z naught ka whole square. And for MAZ plus 1, we put Z plus 1 minus Z naught ka whole square. A gamma is common. So after simplification, this is a simple simplification. We get that it is 2 gamma Z naught minus Z minus half for odd number of nucleons. For the Q value, the transition energy is equivalent to 2 gamma Z naught minus Z minus half. Similarly, for the transition, for the beta plus decay, for beta plus decay, a positron is emitted out. So what is the reaction? Here, ZX plus A reacts to form plus 1 electron 0 beta positive. So when we see the beta positive decay, that is the positron decay. So in the positron decay, a positron is emitted out of the parent nucleus. So let us again consider that the parent nucleus is ZX plus A. In the positron emission, there is an atomic number of plus 1 here. So to conserve the reaction, so Z is here, Z on the right hand side it is plus 1. So the Z on the daughter nucleus should be Z minus 1, such that Z minus 1 plus 1 is again Z on the right hand side, and on the left hand side we had Z. So similarly, the atomic numbers, the mass numbers are conserved here having A because they are isobars. So a positron is emitted out in this reaction, and what we see that this transition is that Z is changing from Z to Z minus 1. So mu beta positive will be given again by the difference of the masses of the parent and the daughter nucleus. So we substitute the value of again MAZ and MAZ minus 1 using equation number 7. So we get the value to be equal to 2 gamma Z minus Z dot minus half. The only basic difference between the Q values of Z plus 1 and Z minus 1 is that here it was Z naught minus Z and here it is Z minus Z naught. Rest the equation is same. So these Q values has been calculated for the odd number of nucleons. So what we have done here, we have plotted a graph of the mass of the nucleus with respect to the atomic number Z. So since it is a parabolic curve, so this is your parabola. Here we are having two types of decays, that is beta minus and beta plus. So what was happening in beta minus decay, Z was changing to Z plus 1. So supposingly this value is Z. So this is a higher value, so this is Z plus 1. So in going for beta minus decay, the Z is changing from Z to Z plus 1. So the beta is going downward. Beta minus is going downward reaction. In the beta plus decay, what was having there? Here it was Z was changing to Z minus 1. So if this value is Z, so this can be taken as Z minus 1. So beta value, beta plus equation or beta plus transition is taking towards this side. It is taking from right hand side to left hand side of the curve. So and this point is the point where we find the most stable nuclei, that is corresponding to Z naught, which is the minimum value. So every transition tries to attain a configuration which is having more stability. It tends to move towards that side which will attain a stable nucleus, that is towards Z naught. So that is why beta minus is shifting from left side to right side towards the Z naught, and beta plus is shifting from right side to left side towards Z naught. If we suppose that there was beta plus reaction here, so what would be happening here? That this is the Z value and this would be Z minus 1 value for beta plus. So beta plus reaction would have gone in the opposite direction to beta minus. So it would have moved away from the most stable nuclei. And similarly, if we consider here beta minus, so beta minus would have moved this side, again away from the most stable nuclei, this side. So we want the transitions, that favorable transitions, which would move to the most stable center, that is toward this. So for this parabolic curve, the left hand side of the curve means that there would be always beta minus decay, and on the right hand side of the curve we will always see a beta positive transition. So these were the calculations done for the odd number of nucleons. So if we consider even number of nucleons, the basic difference in the equation of the mass of the nucleus of the most stable nucleus is alpha A minus gamma Z naught square minus delta, where this delta term has come during the pairing effect. The pairing effect was taken zero in the case of odd number of nucleons. But in the case of even number of nucleons, we have to consider the delta effect. So taking the pairing effect into consideration, so mass of the nucleus of the most stable nucleus will be given by alpha A minus gamma Z naught square minus delta. And carrying the calculations on the similar lines, we get the equation of mass parabola, that is MAZ minus MAZ naught, will be given by gamma Z minus Z naught ka whole square, where for odd number of protons, it would have a plus 2 delta pairing effect, and for even number of protons, it would have a zero value. So this is the equation of mass parabola. And if we calculate the Q values of the reaction, both for beta decay, beta positive, as well as beta negative decay, that is for positron or electron decay, the value of the beta plus minus comes out to be 2 gamma plus minus Z naught minus Z. I already told that there is only difference of plus minus in this term, Z naught and Z. So it will be plus minus Z naught minus Z minus half, that is the same. But only difference in the odd and even number of nucleons is this plus minus 2 delta term. For odd nucleons, there was zero term. But for even nucleons, if we have odd number of protons, the value will be plus delta. And if we have even number of protons, for pairing effect, we will have minus 2 delta value. So this is the Q value given for the odd and even number of nucleons. Similarly, if we see the graph, when we plot the graph for the mass of the nucleus with respect to the number of protons, both for odd value of z and even value of z, and we see the transitions of beta positive and beta negative decay. We have already seen that beta negative will be carried always on the left hand side of the parabolic curve, and beta plus decay will be carried on the right hand side of the parabolic curve. So when there is a beta minus decay in this case, so in the beta minus decay, what was happening? In beta minus decay, z was changing to z plus 1. So if we consider that z is even, so if z is even, so z plus 1 will be odd. So whenever beta negative decay will occur, so what will happen? That the transition will jump from even parabola to the odd parabola. Secondly, whenever again second beta negative transition happens, now this z plus 1 is odd. So again for z plus 2, when again beta negative is reaction, so it will become z from odd, it will jump to even. So there will be a jump from your odd curve to even curve in the beta negative transitions. Similarly, when we see a positron emission, again a positron which was lying, the mass of the nucleus which was lying on the even z curve, it would jump to the odd z curve, and with further beta positive, it would jump again on the even, and successive jumping would take place, how depending upon the number of positrons or number of electrons that are being ejected out. But the tendency is always to move towards the most stable nucleus, that is the center point. So always beta negative transition takes place on the left hand side of the parabola, and on beta positive, always the transition takes place on the right hand side of the parabola, because every system wants to achieve a stability. It would move to a region of higher stability. So in this way, this mass parabola's equations are useful in determining the transition energies, Q values of the reaction. So I hope that I am able to make you understand the concept of mass parabolas, and meet you again. Thank you.